Hey guys, Paulo Sagnaro here from congachops.com. I just want to give you a brief rundown of your new LP conga. Let's talk a little bit about the history of the congas, getting comfortable with your drum, how to tune it, and get you started playing your first groove. So first off, it's important to note that the conga drum sees its inception in Cuba in correlation with the thousands of slaves being brought over predominantly from the Bantu-speaking Congo region of Africa during the 17th and 18th centuries. The conga's closest, most recognizable predecessor is the makuta drum, a tall barrel-shaped drum used in private religious ceremonies of Bantu origin. Now, the conga drum also has some traceable Nigerian roots in the Lukumi Bembe drum, a slightly smaller conga-like drum. Towards the end of the 19th century, the Cuban rumba, which has its roots in the poorer urban neighborhoods of cities like La Habana and Matanzas, is the first established genre to specifically call for a conga drum as part of its standard instrumentation. So now that we have a very brief history on the origin of the congas, let's get to it. So when we sit down at the drum, we want to make sure that we're positioned at a height that allows our arms and hands to be in a neutral resting position. Now, this might entail having your seat a little higher or lower, depending on your height or the length of your arms. But generally speaking, having the drum head somewhere just above the height of our belly button is a good place to start. Now, the same goes for playing standing. We want to make sure that our arms can rest in a neutral position. The congas I have here are three Giovanni Galaxy Series wood drums with LP standard side lug tuning. And I have them set up in a very common way for a right-handed player, with my main drum being my highest pitch drum, and the drum to my right being my lowest pitch drum. Now, the drums you have in front of you might have a top tuning style rim, but in any case, the tips I'll give you here will still apply. So when we go to tune our drums, the most important thing is to adjust the tension evenly to raise or lower the pitch of the drum. To raise the pitch, we'll turn each lug clockwise, a half or quarter turn at a time, as we work our way around the drum. Now, the pitches we choose to tune our drums to will depend heavily on the style of music we're playing, as well as on our own personal taste. So make sure to check out your favorite records, keeping the musical context in mind while you work on replicating the tune. Now in this video, my main drum is tuned to a C sharp, and the drum to my right, the tumbadora, is tuned to an F sharp, a pretty common tuning for a wide variety of musical styles. Now if you're looking for a more in-depth guide to tuning and tips on tuning two or more drums in a variety of different settings, make sure to check out our free tuning guide by clicking the link below. Oftentimes, a conga drum will continue to self-adjust in pitch after we're done tuning. So to avoid the pitch drastically changing, feel free to play a hefty strike in the middle of the drum to force the head to settle a bit, making it easier to maintain the pitch. Now that we have a basic idea of how to tune, let's work on our first groove. This is a simple pattern based on the conga's infamous tumbao pattern that you can use in a pop, funk, rock, or R&B setting that locks up really well depending on what the drummer is playing. And it'll only use a couple of the various sounds we can get out of the drum: open tones, slap tones, and ghost tones. Now you're gonna wanna spend some time working on each of these tones individually. Let's just check out a brief overview of each one to get you started. So to play an open tone, we'll be striking the drum using the meat of our fingers near the edge of the drum. For our next tone, the closed slap tone, we'll focus on striking the drum with the point of impact on our fingers being the crease just opposite our top knuckle joint. Quite different from using the entire surface area of our fingers like we did with our open tones. Now getting a slap tone is a bit trickier than getting an open tone, so don't get discouraged if it takes you some time to develop. Remember that with this tone, we're looking for a crisp, powerful cracking sound. The last tone we'll use in this groove is a ghost tone, and this tone can refer to playing any sound on the conga at a softer volume. So for this groove, we'll just think of it as a softer open tone, striving for a drier, less resonant sound that we'll mainly use for timekeeping. And just so you can hear the difference, I'll play four open tones followed by four ghost tones. Now it's time to put it all together to play our first groove. So we'll use a combination of these three tones slowly to play a hand-to-hand tumbao, which means that we'll be alternating our hands throughout. I'll be starting with my right hand as I'm a right-handed player. So if you're left-handed, feel free to start this pattern with your left. So let's play three ghost tones, followed by a close slap, then two ghost tones, followed by two open tones. One, two, three, four. Now let's work on that one more time, up to speed, over one of the exclusive practice loops included with the CongaChops.com membership. One, two, three, four. So there's just a few simple tips and a super useful groove to get you started playing congas. Now that you have an idea of some of the possibilities, feel free to explore some of the different sounds you can get and jam along with your favorite songs. And if you're interested in learning more about how to play congas in depth and step by step, make sure to head over to congachops.com and grab your free 7-day trial for access to over 50 hours of exclusive lessons.